Hello everyone. In this lecture, we will be discussing about the classical synchronization problems. The meaning of the classical synchronization problem is that there are several situations or the various situations in the computer science that arises, and they need the cooperation or the competition between the processes. So wherever such kind of the situation will take place, we need the synchronization. Now, any other situation of the synchronization will actually land up to these categories only, or they will relate to these categories only. So the one of the classical synchronization problem is the reader's writer's problem. Another one is the dining philosopher problem. Another one is the producer consumer problem. In earlier lectures, I have discussed about the producer consumer problem in detail, and the sleeping barber problem. So these are the situations. These are the classical synchronization problems, and we will see each of these in detail one by one. So to start with, we will be discussing about the reader's writer's problem in this lecture. So what is happening in the reader's writer's problem? That let's say there is a database, and this database needs to be updated. And whenever this database needs to be updated, we will be performing the write operations. And whenever the database has to be read, we will be performing the read operations. Now, thing is like, agar hum write operation perform kar rahe hain, aur usi time pe agar hum dusra write operation bhi perform kar rahe hain same data item pe, so that will actually give us a wrong result, or this may give us the wrong result. Similarly, if I am performing the writing and meanwhile I start reading as well, so the writing operation has not been completed yet, and in between we have started the reading operation, so we can actually come or to land up with the situation of the dirty read, ya fir hum galat data shayad read kar rahe hain database ke item ka. To iska simply meaning ye hai ki agar hum write operations perform kar rahe hain, to we should restrict read, and whenever we are performing the read operation, let's restrict the write operation. Iska ek scenario lete hain, chota sa scenario. Let's say we are interested in the IRCTC ticket booking. So in the IRCTC, there are two options possible, or even three options are possible. One is that you can inquire about a ticket. You can inquire about that, what is the total number of seat available for a particular train. And the next activity is that you can perform is the booking of the ticket, and the other one is that you have already booked the ticket, now you want to cancel that ticket. So in the first situation, when you are inquiring about your ticket, so this actually is the read operation. Or if you are inquiring about the number of the seats in available in the train, then this is a read operation. And then booking of the ticket corresponds to the write operation, because let's say we earlier had n seats available for a particular train. So after the booking of one of the seat, this will reduce to n minus 1. Now similarly for the cancel, if there were n seats available for a particular train in a particular type of the coaches, then it will be incremented by 1. If earlier n seats were available, now that will be incremented to n plus 1, because one seat has been cancelled. So that will be added in the available pool. Now, in case you are booking a ticket, or you are writing on the database with a decrement operation, and meanwhile if you perform the read operation, so earlier this must have been reading n tickets, and after this, after the booking operations, the number of seats will be reduced to n minus 1. So even if we are at the inquiring, or we are inquiring the tickets or the number of seats available, it will be reading n only. However, the number of seats can be reduced to n minus 1. So this inquiry operation is reading the wrong data. Okay, let's say there is only one seat available. So this usually happens when we are doing the tatkal booking. A very limited number of the seats are available. So there is only one seat available, and this one seat is shown to us through the inquiry. Now, when you are inquiring, in between somebody books the ticket, so this count reduces to 0. Fine. And even then you are actually reading one only, so you will attempt the ticket booking, so this attempt is actually the wrong. So That means that whenever you are writing something, you should restrict the read operation. And when you are reading something, until the reads complete, avoid the writing operations also. So this actually is the reader's writer's problem, wherein while the readings are performed, we will wait for the read operations to complete, then we will start writing. And when the writing operations are performed, we will wait till the completion of a write operation, then we will start the reading operation or another write operation. Okay, we are not allowing the simultaneous read write operations also. Write operation ek complete hoga tabhi hum dusre write operation ko start karenge. Okay, so we can say that the writing of the item in a file or in any entity or in any database is mutually exclusive. So this actually is a synchronization problem wherein we have to restrict the number of writes and the number of read operations. Okay, now to find out the solution of this problem, we are taking three mutual exclusion variables. In fact, two mutual exclusion variables. One is the RW mutex that actually is telling you that whether the write operation can be performed or not. This semaphore value is initialized to one. If the RW mutex value is one, it means that the writing can be performed. If the value of this is zero, the writing cannot be performed. Now another thing is the semaphore mutex. Whenever we are doing the updations, then updations in the number of writes and the number of reads, we should be in a mutually exclusive mode so that the other cannot perform the similar thing. So there are two mutual exclusion variable available here or that we are using for the solution. One is the RW mutex, another one is only mutex. Both are initialized to one, meaning that we are going to deal with the situation of the binary semaphore. We are dealing with the binary semaphore because the mutex variables have been initialized to one. So they can take only two values, one or zero. Another thing is the read count that will be telling you that how many read operations are being performed as of now. Initially, we will not be performing any read operation, so this quantity will be zero. Now let's look at the solution of the reader's writer's problem. For finding out the solution of the reader's writer's problem, first look at the writer problem. So for writing, we need to ensure that there is no other writing is being performed. Okay, for writing, we will have to ensure that no other writing is being performed at the moment. So now to ensure this, we first call the wait function and see what is the value of the RW mutex. If the value of the RW mutex is one, it means that the writing operation can be performed. So by the wait operation, you bring this value to zero and then you enter the critical section, which is the operation of writing the file or writing the database. Now after the writing is performed or the writing is completed, you should signal RW mutex, meaning that you should make the value of RW mutex from 0 to 1 so that if other person is interested in writing, he can enter the critical section, or if other process is interested in writing, then that process can enter the mutual exclusion for writing operations. Okay, enter the critical section, not the mutual exclusion. So this writer solution to the writer's problem is ensuring that if the writing is already being performed, you should wait. Let's say the value of, or the current value of the RW mutex is zero. So if that value is zero, in that case it will keep waiting. Okay, we are actually doing the busy waiting solution for this reader's writer's problem. So if the RW mutex value is zero, we will keep waiting, and once this value becomes one, then only I can enter for the writing operations. And once the writing operation is completed, then I can signal the RW mutex so that if any other process is interested in doing the writing operation, that process can do the writing. So this is the solution to the writer's problem. Now let's look at the solution to the reader's problem or reader's process. So what happens that for the reading operations, we need to ensure that no writing is being performed. Okay, no writing is performed. So we are starting with a mutex variable because every check that we need to apply should be mutually exclusive. No other process should be checking these things if this process is doing this. So mutex, wait mutex means the value of the mutual exclusion variable was initially one. We have brought it down to zero. And now the read count is updated by one. If the earlier read count was zero, now the read count must have become one. Now, if this is the first read operation, if this is the first read operation, obviously if the read count will be one, it means this is the first read operation. देन वी शुड चेक कि कहीं राइटिंग ऑपरेशन तो परफॉर्म नहीं हो रहा है. सो इफ राइटिंग ऑपरेशन इज ऑलरेडी परफॉर्म, वी विल एक्चुअली नॉट परफॉर्म द रीडिंग ऑपरेशन. सो वी आर वेटिंग टिल द राइटिंग ऑपरेशन आर कंप्लीटेड. सो इफ आर डब्ल्यू म्यूटेक्स इज जीरो देन वी विल वेट. इफ द आर डब्ल्यू म्यूटेक्स इज वन देन आई विल ब्रिंग दिस वैल्यू फ्रॉम वन टू जीरो. आर डब्ल्यू म्यूटेक्स की वैल्यू को हम वन से जीरो लेके आएंगे. ताकि दो दो इसके रीजंस हैं. पहला ये है कि अगर राइटिंग हो रही है तो हम रीडिंग ना करें. दूसरा क्या है कि अगर हम रीडिंग परफॉर्म करने जा रहे हैं तो भी जो है हम राइटिंग को रेस्ट्रिक्ट करते हैं. इसीलिए हमने वन से जीरो किया आर डब्ल्यू म्यूटेक्स की वैल्यू को. एंड नाउ व्हेन ऑल दिस चेक्स विल बी परफॉर्म्ड आई विल सिग्नल म्यूटेक्स, ताकि कोई और प्रोसेस अगर देखना चाहता है इस म्यूटेक्स की वैल्यू को और आर डब्ल्यू म्यूटेक्स को तो वो देख सके. आफ्टर दिस द रीडिंग ऑपरेशन आर परफॉर्म्ड एंड वंस द रीडिंग ऑपरेशन हैव गॉट कंप्लीटेड then what we will have to do, we will have to check if no read operations are active now, so hum writing ko allow kar dein. theek hai, so let's see. after performing the reading you should decrement the read count. if the read count was earlier 7, so I have brought it down to 6 because we are ensuring that simultaneous read operations can be performed. that's why I have brought this value from 7 to 6. ab isi process mein अगर मान लीजिए कि रीड काउंट की वैल्यू 7 9 के 1 होती तो हम इसको 1 से 0 करते काउंट माइनस माइनस से. एंड देन अगर इस काउंट की वैल्यू 0 है तो उस केस में हम राइटिंग अलाउ कर देते. सो हमने देखिए कि जब रीड काउंट की वैल्यू 1 थी, इसका मतलब जब पहला राइट ऑपरेशन हो रहा था, सो हमने इस वाली लाइन से इंश्योर किया था कि राइट ऑपरेशन को हमने रेस्ट्रिक्ट कर दिया है. अभी अगर रीड काउंट 0 हो गया तो इसका मतलब क्या है कि अब राइट के लिए हम फिर से तैयार हैं. तो आर डब्ल्यू म्यूटेक्स जिसकी वैल्यू 0 हो गई थी, अब हम इसको 1 कर देंगे. नाउ इसके बाद सिग्नल म्यूटेक्स करेंगे. रिवेट म्यूटेक्स के साथ हमने ये सारी चेक अप्लाई किए थे, इसीलिए सिग्नल म्यूटेक्स कर देंगे ताकि कोई दूसरा प्रोसेस इसी को चेक करना चाहे तो वो देख सकता है. सो द क्रक्स इज दैट व्हेनेवर वी आर डूइंग द राइटिंग ऑपरेशन देन द रीडिंग शुड नॉट परफॉर्म, एंड व्हेनेवर वी आर डूइंग द रीडिंग ऑपरेशन देन द राइटिंग शुड नॉट परफॉर्म. नाउ लेट्स टेक अ सिनेरियो दैट रीडिंग्स आर ऑलरेडी परफॉर्म. So let's say 5 reading operations are already active. So the value of count will be 5. And we are going to do the next reading operation. So when we are going to do the next reading operation, the first thing is that we should increment this count to 6. So the earlier value of the count was 5. I have incremented this count to 6. After incrementing this, if the read count is 1, obviously it is not because the read count is 6. So if read count is first, then only we need to restrict the writing operation. If the read count is already 5, then we must have already restricted the writing operation by setting up the RW mutex value as 0 through the wait operation. So no need to check it again or no need to update it again. It must already have been done when first reading operation was performed. So it is just that you have incremented the count and then you should perform the reading operation. And once the reading operation gets completed, you should decrement the read count. So once the reading operation has got completed, let's bring it down to 5, the count of the read operations. And if this count is not 0, then no need of doing anything else. You just exit. So you are actually allowing the simultaneous read operations to perform. And when the reading operations are performed, we are restricting the writing operations. And whenever the reading operations are performed, we will restrict the writing operation. Whenever the writing operations are performed, we will restrict the read operations. Now there is a variation of this. For example, let's say we are dealing with the IRCTC ticket booking only. Let's say we are doing the IRCTC ticket booking only. So enquiry jo operation hai, for enquiry operations to hamesha on hai. लेकिन वी विल ऑलवेज गिव द प्रायोरिटी टू द बुकिंग ऑपरेशन. इसका मतलब क्या है कि बुकिंग की या राइटिंग ऑपरेशंस की जो प्रायोरिटी है वो होनी चाहिए. जो जब भी व्यक्ति कोई भी व्यक्ति टिकट बुकिंग करना चाहता है तो वो कर सकता है. तो रीडिंग ऑपरेशंस अगर इंक्वायरी है और राइटिंग ऑपरेशन अगर बुकिंग ऑफ टिकट है, सो वी विल गिव द प्रायोरिटी टू द राइटिंग ऑपरेशन. सो दिस इज द फर्स्ट राइटर प्रायोरिटी, समथिंग लाइक द फर्स्ट राइटर प्रायोरिटी. सो राइटर प्रोसेसेस आर गिवन द प्रायोरिटी ओवर द रीडर्स प्रोसेसेस. And there is another variation of this wherein the reader's operations are given, reader processes are given the higher priority. So first reader priority. So these are the two variations of the reader's writer's process, wherein we are applying some priority also along with the reading and the writing operations. So that means if the reading operations are performed and the writer process comes in, so writer will get the priority by removing all the reading operations. And when the writer operation is coming, or when the reader operation is coming, and we are in the first reader's priority, then the reader operations will be getting the priority in this case. So these are the two variations of the reader's writer's problem. Thank you.